Hello folks, and welcome back to the Borgia-inspired Orsini playthrough of Crusader Kings II. The year is 1102, and we're not really any closer to getting a pope of our family, or of our dynasty, but we are, however, we do have another county, and we're a duke, so that's nice, and we are also fabricating a claim on Capua. And we are allied with, like, everyone on the planet, maybe. I don't know. Another thing as well is I noticed that, I've been playing an Iron Man for the first time in Crusader Kings 2. However, I just realized I didn't get any achievements, so I don't know what's up with the save game. I'm not running any mods other than the Novus Graphicus, which you can get on the Steam Workshop, but... yeah, I might have to change that, because, I don't know, we'll see. No, my son is dead. Wait, poor health, what a bastard, age 42, okay, right, so my grandson's the heir, I guess. Wait, who's, it's the firstborn, right, and he's pretty decent, although the brother is amazing as well, but we'll go for the firstborn. Acclaim, finally, okay, wonderful. I need to use it before I die, I'm kind of old, so we should declare war very soon. Actually, now. I just love having so many allies. Look, just Apulia's gonna help me, Byzantine Empire, Denmark, Urbino, and France. It's just, ugh, wonderful. Oh, and apparently the Zirid Sultanate is attacking our liege for the Duchy of Capua, so yeah, we've got to defend that. And the King of France is going to marry my daughter, or no, yeah, my daughter. Wonderful. Apparently this guy owes me a favor, but I don't know why and how, so whatever. Oh right, I helped him with his work. Okay, cool. Enforce demands, and voila. We are a three-county duke, and we can create the Duchy of Capua as well. Should we? I don't know. We don't exactly have a lot of money right now. Actually, it would prevent it from passing out to someone else, so of course I needed that. Now I'm gonna ask the Pope to give my unlanded son some land. I think he'll say no, but you know, I'm just gonna lose 20 prestige and see how that event chain works. Alright, not in his art. My grandson Giorgio names his son Giorgio, but okay, sure, go ahead. Oh no, that bastard Pope is trying to revoke my county. I don't know what to do. There will have to be war. That's the only solution. Alright, so I called in one favor, and then I convinced two others to vote like me in the next 36 months. Maybe useless, I don't know. I just felt like using that mechanic. I'm still gonna die soon, and I'm hoping the Pope dies soon as well. I mean, he's 76. How much longer can he last? There we go, new heir. You know, lost a lot of people. Let's see. He died of stress. Poor man. New heir, yeah, whatever. So who am I? Albredo the second? No, the grandson, yes. Right. Wonderful. New Pope. Wonderful. I must remind the Pope of his promise. Yet another new Pope. Huh. Of course, these guys die all the time. Old people, you know. Venice is no longer a merchant republic, apparently. Actually, since quite a long time. Hmm. Ah, I'm doing it. I'm betrothing my daughter to the King of Hungary. I don't know, it's not actually that useful, but I just really like spreading my seed all over the place and having these super powerful allies. No. Why not? Shit, oops. Apulia has become Sicily. Wonderful, although he wants the County of Capua, so he doesn't like me that much anymore. You know what, let's centralize the realm just a little bit more so we can get more provinces. I think we had more in favor than against, so that's wonderful. Hey, the Lombard populace in Capua have embraced Italian culture. I didn't even realize they were Lombards down there. So that's good. The Knights of St. John, welcome. Actually, the other day my mousepad, my new gaming mousepad, arrived from the Paradox store or whatever, and also a little Crusader Kings 2 flask. The mousepad is actually the Crusader Kings 2 one, so it has the way of life portrait with a king in the middle, trying to being seduced by the by Eve or the devil there, trying to give him an apple, and on the other side like a priest and the family and all these values, you know, that you get to choose in life. Now my focus here is to groom an heir, and family gives me plus 25% fertility, and the grooming an heir gives me plus 20%, but my wife is kind of old, so I'm thinking maybe we should like do seduction and work on it that way. Let's do that. I tried seducing pretty much all the young women in my court. Didn't really work, so we're gonna have to move abroad on our search for stuff. Actually, nomination of bishop, let me just check if he'd do it. No, because he doesn't like me enough. I must be really, really ugly, because, like, everyone rejects me. What's up with that? Is it because I'm a family man? That doesn't make sense, though. Literally everyone. Oh god, what is up with this? Ah, finally, there we go. Meet in my room, my lady. Should we let our love grow? Yes, because I want bastards. I need children. She probably knows, but I'm gonna lie to her face because I'm that stone cold. What is this? Ah, yes, of course. There is no way I cannot have a child with my lover. Like, seduction focus, groom an heir, and the lustful trait. Like, that is just insane fertility bonuses that right there. Oh no, King Henry II is dead, but my aunt is the mother, so I should be able to... No? Okay. Time to relieve my brother of his command of the mercenary company, get him back over to my court, because these children here will come very handy for alliances and such. The Knights Templar, welcome, welcome, Grandmaster. Do you have any land? No, okay. Ugh, I hate when this happens. Like, my brother came back, but I can't interact with his children. Like, they're in my court, but I can't, like, you know, marry them off and all of that, which is rather annoying. So he gets to decide just because he's the heir, maybe? No, that wouldn't make sense. Revoke honorary title? No. I don't know how to fix that. Is that a bug or is it intended to be like that? Oh, we have a new color for those Seljuk Turks, finally. I actually used to think that their previous color was kind of disgusting. It's not bad, it's just that you've got lots of green in the Middle East here, and the Seljuks had this, like, lime green that just didn't go well together with the rest. I think this is kind of nice. It also goes well together with the tribes, and you kind of know that they're an invader, or... Well, that's disputable, but you get what I mean. Four lovers, that's a record for me, actually, so that's amazing. Let's keep going at it. Still no children. I guess it's kind of likely that my younger brother will inherit. And that's five. How many can I have, actually? I wonder. Ah, finally a son, although he's a bastard and he's not of the dynasty, so he gets lowborn. His name shall be Victor. Actually, yeah, I could legitimize him. Is he any intelligent? He's a bastard. You know what? Let's legitimize him. Six lovers. I mean, I don't think there is a limit. Let's try to go for 10. Another daughter. Let's acknowledge her, I guess. I don't know. Sanction as my daughter and can be married off to form alliances. Let's acknowledge her, but not let her be of my dynasty. I mean, I also like to control the size of the dynasty. If you think about it, it's just sometimes it can be too big. It's a pity that I'm in a war with this guy and ally to him, because right now I could pretty much just go ahead and claim the throne in favor of the wife of my brother, which means that her heir would be someone of my dynasty, which would be amazing, right? Except that would be getting out of the focus, because my focus is playing semi-realistically, trying to keep myself small and get a pope on the throne, or not a pope, but you know, someone of our dynasty on the pope throne. The Pope chair. Alright, another daughter. Let's acknowledge her. Thing is, yeah, I should keep finding more lovers just for fun. The hedonist trait is great, but the church opinion and all of that stuff, I don't know. I'm gonna go for a master seducer, because then I can just seduce everybody, right? Wonderful. I actually just seduced the sister of the Holy Roman Emperor, who's the Duchess of Upper Burgundy. Hehe. Oh, we officially have a nickname, the Lewd of Latium. yes, I think that encapsulates us very well. Another son, let's legitimize him. My wife probably hates me. Well, yeah, of course. Ah, lovely. Haven't seen this one before. So my spy master, who's my nephew, said that, oh, we should take some precaution, have a guard to protect you, because it's, you know, there could be spies and stuff. And so I go into the dining hall, and apparently there is a pelican guard. And yeah, I could get wounded here, but whatever. Ah, lovely, lovely. Was I wounded? No, I'm still stressed. Because, you know, having, what is it, still 7, 9 lovers is quite stressful. Ah, finally! I have seduced the Duchess of Caravuna. Right, let our love grow. So the sister of Duchess Matilda of Flanders, who I just happened to seduce, and knows what I'm up to, so she's trying to blackmail me into paying her, and 24 ducats, you know, that's nothing in my coffers, so fine. New Pope, and he's actually young! Wow, 37! This guy, we're gonna be keeping around for a while. He wants me as a counselor. Wonderful, let's make sure we are loyalists, and we vote in whatever way he wants us to vote. I actually really want our opinion to go up, because this guy could actually appoint the bishops that I need. Oh, it happened out of nowhere. Let's see who succeeded Duke Barnaba. So, of course, or not of course, but the mercenary captain who was out for so long is finally ruling over the realm, and his brother's children might be a danger, but they're very young, so it's fine. As for the rest, I don't know. But Barnaba died under suspicious circumstances. I worry. Maybe the wife tried to make that happen, or maybe I did. Who knows? The Pope wants to become the guardian of Victor Orsini. Sure, of course. Go ahead. Oh man, I'm kind of ugly being old like this. Quite a pity. Thing is, since this guy's so young, I really think that we can make him our friend and nominate a bishop. Although we don't really have that many candidates, but in any case, What I think I'm gonna do is just wait up until we can change our focus so that we can carouse him. I think I can do that to a liege. Normally I'm independent by this point, but I'll see. God damn, this is so tempting. I could claim the Kingdom of Sicily for my wife to have it, and then that would pass on to my heir right now, my current heir. Again, though, my rules were we're not gonna be independent from the Pope when we have the Pope on the throne. So, as much as I really want to do it, we're gonna try to keep ourselves controlled and not play to conquer the world this time. My brother died in battle. In battle where? What the hell? Ah, a granddaughter. Marcella sounds good. And so it begins, the Second Crusade. We never seem to not be at war since we have so many allies. But yes, this crusade will probably fail, as always. Let's see. Let's actually go ahead and join the crusade. I know I'm the vassal of the Pope, so technically we're already at war, but we aren't eligible to get the actual titles. Let's see. Yes, of course. But I'm not going to send any troops there, because again, I don't want the kingdom, and the crusade's still going to fail, so whatever. Because by joining the crusade, we raise the opinion with the Pope, and we get a maybe of the bishop nomination, which is great. I'm thinking of nominating Giorgio, even though he's maimed, or maybe... Oh yeah, there's two Giorgios, right? Yeah, maybe it will be this Giorgio, even though he's kind of stupid. I'll see. We'll still have to change our focus, though. I had a heart attack. I was like, the Pope is dead? No, it's the anti-Pope that just happened to pass away, because I was like, it's impossible. Oh, wow, this guy is very young. Wow. See, these crusades, they're pathetic. Look at it. Just look at this. They're all split up. They're stupid. I also just had an idea. If we build a temple, we can actually give it to someone in our family. We don't exactly have the candidate right now, but you know, maybe we will have one once we're done. So let's do it. The anti-papacy has ended finally, and the defensive pact opposing. Okay, good. Ah, a new anti-pope, Ioannis. I can't even pronounce that. The 19th. That's impressive. Prospero Orsini, son of Prospero, I hereby make you Bishop of Alviano. Congratulations, you're the first bishop in the family, and you could very well be Pope one day. I hope perhaps we can raise your score in some way in order to increase your chances, and I think you will show up eventually. You have a good learning, you're Italian, and yeah, you increase your opinion and then we'll work it out. Oh, and best of all, you're young, so that's really good. Oh no, the French are in Algiers, look at that. A bit of an early arrival, I'd say, but quite amazing. Actually, she's my cousin. Are you? Who's of my family? Someone's of them. Okay, my aunt is your mother. And then you have this guy, Urbano, right? Okay. Oh, my son died of leprosy. At least he had a couple of children before going off into the next world, which makes them the heirs of the County of Treviso. Good. But otherwise, bad. Pretty bad. I wish I had more people around. Pneumonia, right. That might kill me soon. Doesn't look like I'll be able to use my carousing focus anytime soon, so I might actually go ahead and change that. I should probably stop allying like half of the world. Where can I even see my allies? I can't. Okay. Let's actually ask our liege for a title. Let's see if he goes for it. He has a barony in Rome, which could be useful. We'll see. If he says no, I might actually change my stance in the council. I cannot... this is futile. Disappointing. You know, I just realized that thanks to our great intervention on the part of Livia, being the mother of Ugo here, he's an Italian king of France, and his heir is also Italian, so that's kind of cool, and we just married off our nephew to the sister of the king, and hopefully they get lots of children, which gets them acclaim, and this line here is looking kind of thin, so maybe that could disappear. Alright, I think I've experimented around with this mechanic enough. There's no need for it, and I don't think we actually earn that much money. I've been checking. So I'm gonna go ahead and disband the mercenary company. Was not happy. He's reported to have taken your soldiers as his own and has disappeared. Well, whatever. Fuck it. He ran away to Cremona, but I'm... you know what? I'm not gonna murder him. I'm gonna leave him alone. There we go. I'm dead. Let's see how I died. Severe stress. Long live Leonello of Latium. Okay, so be it. What's this? Appoint counselor, of course. And then there's all the usual stuff to deal with. What is this? Okay, right. I thought maybe he tried to murder the father, but of course not. He was a kind son. Or I am. The crusade for Jerusalem fails. No shit. Of course it did. Another daughter, let's see, Lucrezia, of course, if you watch the Borgias, of course, you know, Lucrezia, I like that name, let's have it. Oh, that bastard, Bishop Prosper of Alviano was murdered on the orders of Giorgio Orsini, someone in our family, that fucking bastard, where's Giorgio? Oh, you, it's either him or him, oh. I hate you so... oh man, I fucking hate you. What is the point? What is the point? We just lost a bishopric. We just lost the potential to have a cardinal. Do you know what you've done? I'm gonna fucking kill you. 99%. Close. I hope you die, you bastard. And now that guy that took over after our kinsman died is, very close to be the most likely successor to a cardinalship. You know what, let's fund his campaign a little bit. Oh, it's just so disappointing. Fucking families, you know? The drama. The Pope is dead, long live the Pope. I didn't know, like, this guy was 55. I never expected him to die. He died a maimed cripple. Yeah, I guess it was the Crusades that killed him. Let's, of course, accept the position of Chancellor and keep going. Ugh, my daughter died. And she was actually pretty good, brooding, willful. It was working out pretty well for her. Oh, look at that, House Botticelli. Wonderful. I wonder if he will become a great painter. Ah, the bastard who killed our wonderful bishop is dead, a maimed cripple. He deserves it. Very well. Yeah. Bastard. Oh my god. The papacy has free investiture. You know what this means? I just realized I could have improved relations with my bishops all along. And look at that. Now we can appoint two bishops. Life is made so much easier. Wow. Lovely, now we've just got to improve relations with these guys and get more children's. Children? Yeah, not children's. Whatever. Whatever. We've got to get more people to actually appoint. Ah, screw it, we're going theology focus. And look at this, Spoleto just declared a war with me as their only ally against the Holy Roman Empire. Against the rule of the Kaiser. This is just ridiculous, like, the Kaiser has 30,000 troops, so no, we're gonna lose. The blasphemous feelings shall soon pass, or will soon. Can't even read. What is this? I forced me to cancel. Alright, yeah, because the war just broke out. I have gained the just straight. Wonderful. I still can't believe that we have free investiture in the Papal States. It just doesn't make sense. Like, wow. Oh well, that's good for us, because then we can, you know, just corrupt ourselves in. Jihad for Africa. Well, whatever. A daughter to Victor. Ermenegilda. I don't even know. I probably butchered that. Sorry. We're gonna do it. We're gonna go seduction, because I need a male heir. I know it won't give us the thing, but the grooming area gives us plus 20% fertility, so... Oh well. Right, I realize I'm the commander of... a commander in the Papal Army, and the thing is, I'm leading... always leading these troops here in Rome, which is stupid. So, I'm gonna resign so I can actually go ahead and get myself a lover, or a few lovers. My wife is dead. It's a blessing. So now I can find someone that will give me a male heir. That would be so good. Giacinta of France it is. It says I don't get a non-aggression pact, but she is the daughter of the King of France, so I think that should actually give me something. It wouldn't make sense otherwise. What is this? Ah, she doesn't like me. Whatever. 100 prestige or 75 gold. Prestige. But hey, I just realized we have played 50 years or just over that, and this is probably a good place to end the episode at. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Game Gapster as always. Don't forget to leave a like, it really helps the channel out. And subscribe if you haven't already. Also, don't forget to leave a comment if you have any suggestions or ideas. And farewell.